sharp observation, cutting repartee. So acid in their strange and solemn humor, enlightened so our tables. Conversation, he helped dispel and chase away the darkness. The plague, our uninvited guest, has cast upon our best and brightest brilliant.
Thank you. visited your country's hills and valleys. Moaning pitiful laments had sounded down brooks and streams, along the shores of rivers, which now run peacefully and happy through your land's wild paradise. That gloomy year, when myriad had fallen, good-hearted, proud, pure and noble souls, that year stopped memory barely left a trace to some forgotten simple shepherd song, so mournful and so pleasing. There is no that brings such sadness to our celebration as the pining, yearning sound that echoes in.
Drives it. had a manly heart. But here you see, the cruel's weaker than the tender. In fear inhabits souls, tortured by passions.
Some water, Mary, on her face.
Graveyard.
knocks and clatters. What can be done? How can we fight? As from the winter's blast we hide. We'll also lock the plague outside.
We'll also lock the plague outside.
Fire's light,
fire's light.
Fill the cellar. And merrily our minds will drown through its peace and hope for solace. We'll glorify a plague's new crown.
Or do you think that now she is not weeping? not shedding bitter tears in that high heaven where she sees her only son reveling at a tormented feast and hears your voice, these frantic songs of madness singing amidst both holy prayer and sighing lamentation. Come, follow me!
And my embrace was paradise. sake.
He's a bad man.
Holy Father.
He's talking to his